Good evening. Welcome to this fall performance by the Bob Jones University Chorale. We have prepared a challenging and we hope meaningful program for you, which we have entitled Sehnsucht, Songs of Longing. As the ideas for this concert began to develop in my mind, I first envisioned a program that would be centered around the theme of childhood nostalgia. The two pieces that you see in the program tonight, which formed the core of this idea, were Eric Whitaker's setting of the ubiquitous childhood story, Goodnight Moon, and Sarah Teasdale's evocative text, Only in Sleep, beautifully set by Latvian composer Erik Eschenvalds. I had also discovered a couple Estonian folk songs that focused on the theme of childhood nostalgia. And at this point, I do want to recognize two special people, one of whom cannot be with us tonight, and they are Heli and Benjamin Withrow. Heli grew up in Estonia, and her son Benjamin, though he was born in the United States, spent his childhood immersed in the culture and the language of Estonia. And so providentially, I came across Benjamin, and he graciously agreed to come every Friday more or less this semester and help us with the Estonian pronunciation for the two pieces that you see in your program. And his mom, Heli, agreed to translate them for us. We could have found a translation on the internet, but I wanted something that was special for our program tonight, and she agreed to translate them for us. As I pondered what additional pieces to add to the program, I came across this definition for nostalgia that provided a new angle for me. It was in a sermon in which the preacher said, quote, "If you look up the definition of nostalgia, it will say something like a sentimental longing for the past or a melancholy affection for something that is lost. But here's how I would put it. Nostalgia is the powerful, dangerous, but ultimately God-given sense that life would be better if I could just get back home." That was it. For me, the key that unlocked the door to our program. You may have noticed our invitation circulating around campus in a form of a poster or a postcard or perhaps a social media post. And the design for this poster was very intentional. It features a bleak background out of which grows a lone blue flower. And during the German Romantic movement, the blue flower came to symbolize the idea of Sehnsucht, or an insatiable longing. C.S. Lewis would later reflect on his childhood, saying of the beautiful English landscapes that he would view out his window, "They taught me longing, Sehnsucht, made me, for good or ill, and before I was 6 years old, a votary of the blue flower." Our program this evening will explore this complex theme of Sehnsucht, longing for beauty, for satisfaction, for a place that we can truly call home. In conclusion, I offer you one last paragraph from C.S. Lewis from his book, The Weight of Glory. Lewis writes, "In speaking of this desire for our own far-off country, which we find in ourselves even now, I feel a certain shyness. I am almost committing indecency. I am trying to rip open this inconsolable secret in each one of you, the secret that hurts so much that you take your revenge on it by giving it names like nostalgia, or romanticism, or adolescence. The secret we cannot hide and cannot tell, though we desire to do both. We cannot tell it because it is a desire for something that has never actually appeared in our experience. We cannot hide it because our experience is constantly suggesting it. Our common expedient is to call it beauty and behave as though that had settled the matter. Wordsworth's expedient was to identify it with certain movements in his own past. But all this is a cheat. If Wordsworth had gone back to those moments in his past, he would not have found the thing itself, but only the reminder of it. What he remembered would turn out to be itself a remembering. The books or the music in which we thought the beauty was located will betray us if we trust in them. It was not in them, it only came through them. And what came through them was longing. These things, the beauty, the memory of our own past, are good images of what we really desire, But if they are mistaken for the thing itself, they turn into dumb idols, breaking the heart of the worshipers. For they are not the thing itself, they are only the scent of a flower we have not found, the echo of a tune we have not heard, and news from a country that we have not yet visited. Would you pray with me? Our Father, we are grateful for the gift of music. We are grateful for the beauty that we find in all of life's experiences. And we are thankful that through these things we can look to you, the one who is the source of all beauty, the one who is all beautiful. And it's in his name that we pray. Amen.
running, 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 running.